I made a video a long time ago that tried to build intuition about how a compressor works, and since I do not want to repeat myself, this video is not going to explain the build in depth, but rather look at how you can make your compressor sound different. A compressor has basically three elements: peak detector, gain reduction, and multiplication, which is where we apply the gain reduction to the signal. The peak detector is something that smooths out the signal in some ways. Smoothing can be done using envelope followers or using the RMS value. I don't like the RMS way, so I always stick to envelope followers. In my simple setup, I use two envelope followers, one for the attack and one for the release. To understand why, we have to understand how envelope followers work first. So let's jump into this rabbit hole. If the attack and release values of an envelope follower match, the outputs can be matched to simple one-pole low-pass filters. This is because it is nothing more than a simple one-pole low-pass filter. The trick is that it uses a different cutoff value when the value received at the input is lower than the value at its output, and for the opposite case. The envelope follower only rises when the input level is higher than the output level. If a short transient comes in, the envelope follower will not pick up the transient as much as we want. If we put a releasing envelope follower in front of the envelope follower that is responsible for the attack, things suddenly start to work fine. So I suggest using two envelope followers for peak detection, since you want to pick up these short transients. Now we have a basic peak detector. Let's take a look at the gain reduction. We built this in the earlier video, but I'm going to rebuild it now. I just take the absolute value of the envelope, convert it to decibels, and subtract the threshold from it. I clamp the result to zero by adding the absolute value of the signal to itself and multiplying by 0.5. I like this method because it is more efficient than using an if statement, and it can be easily extended into a nee later. We need to multiply the clamped value by the ratio. We just take the reciprocal of the ratio, subtract it from 1, and then invert the result of the multiplication and convert the signal back to the linear domain. The result is gain reduction. Now we can multiply the signal by the gain reduction, set up the parameters for our compressor, and start to play around with it. This setup is called feedforward compression. Of course, there's the opposite called feedback compression. In feedback compression, we have to change the order of the elements first. The signal goes straight into the multiplication and from there to the output and the detector. The output of the detector goes into the gain reduction, and the gain reduction is fed into the other input of the multiplication. Simple. To make this work properly, we need to change the way the gain reduction works. We only need to subtract the ratio from 1, and the product of the multiplication does not need to be inverted. That's all. Now we have two flavors of compression at our disposal: feedback and feedforward. Let's go back to the envelope followers. They attack and release nicely and do their job fine. but we can smooth the spikes out by using more of them. By using four envelope followers chained together, we can obtain a curve that looks and feels a lot smoother. But the attack and release times have changed. We need to compensate for them. Take the number of envelope followers used and take the square root of this number. We can get the square root using the power function. Raising a number to the 0.5th power is the square root. Let's take the reciprocal of this and multiply the attack and release times by this value. Magic! The attack and release times of the four envelope followers match those of the single envelope follower, but the curves are smooth. Let's apply this knowledge to the peak detector. Let's copy and paste the original envelope follower pair and chain them up. Using the function from before, we obtain a smooth peak detector, and we can also crossfade between the two detector functions to get something really unique. We can also introduce soft knee by extending the clamp in the gain reduction. Instead of the absolute value, we can multiply the signal by itself and then take the square root of it using the power function. We did not change anything, this setup equals the absolute value. But if we insert an addition before the square root, we can control the knee of the gain reduction. The knee value needs to be squared, however. From this point on, the possibilities are pretty much endless. You can choose the compressor topology to your liking, experiment with different envelope follower and smoothing techniques, or combine existing ones. You can also filter the sidechain or add saturation to the signal at different stages of the process. The planned part of the video ends here, but as I was working on editing, I realized that all this may be too involved and not too practical for everyone. So I thought of a way to simplify all of this. I've created a bunch of designers that add up to a modular compressor system. It features peak detectors, gain reducers, auto makeup helpers, and designers for simplifying the multiplication and the drive-at mixing. Combined with existing nodes, you can get really complex and interesting results. Alpha Forever users can grab the setup from our Discord channel. I've enjoyed working on this video and learned a lot of new things along the way. I hope you've also found this interesting. If so, then don't forget to leave a comment or like the video. It helps a lot. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.